Good morning students, how are you? I hope all of you are fine. Today we will revise lesson number 7, Not Enough Food. What does it mean? It means that there is shortage of food due to some reasons. What are these reasons? We will read these reasons in our video. Our body is like a machine. Yes. This works like a machine. Like a machine, we all need energy to work. Like a car, we need petrol or diesel to run a car. So in the same way, we need energy to run our body, because our body needs energy to do work, to play and to do other activities. From where do we get this energy? We get this energy from the food we eat. Yes, food gives us energy. That means food is very important for us. We cannot live without food. First topic is famine. So what is famine? The condition when people do not get enough food for a long period of time is called famine. Yes, this is the condition when people do not get enough food. Jab logon ko khana nahi milta to eat over a long period of time, bahut lambe time tak, us condition ko bola jata hai famine. Famines are caused by two reasons. First is natural calamities, which are not under our control because they are created by nature. And second is human created problems. Yes, due to some human beings and their urge to get more profit, they create some problems which makes shortage of food. So first is natural calamities. Natural calamities includes earthquakes, floods, droughts, plant diseases, volcanic eruptions. They can damage the crops and lead to shortage of food. Yes, water plays an important role in crop production because irrigation. And in especially India, most of the farmers depend on rainwater only. And when there is little or no rain, no crops grow. So that means there is failure of crops, and this leads to shortage of food. Again, when there is excessive rainfall, it causes floods. So crops also get destroyed in the same condition. So these natural calamities damage the crops and lead to shortage of food. Next is human created problems. What does human beings do? First is hoarding and black marketing. Hoarding means the hiding and storing of food grains to get extra profit from the people is called hoarding. In order to earn more profit, some shopkeepers, some wholesalers, what do? They hide and store food grains in their godowns, and later on when there is shortage of food grains, then this food grains are sold at high price, which is called black marketing. So it is illegal and punishable by law, but people do this for money. They get extra money by this, but poor people cannot purchase these food grains at high prices. So this is an illegal method. Now next is improper food storage. We can see in the kitchen also, if we store some pulses or some grains and if they have some moisture, then they are destroyed. So storage of food grains should be done in godowns that are free from microorganisms, insects or rats, because they can damage our crops, and this destruction also leads to shortage of food. So the grains should be dried properly, and the godown in which they are going to be stored, it should be free from microorganisms, insects and rats. Next is, yes, in India there are many people who do not have enough money to buy food, and some of them get only one meal a day. So they suffer from malnutrition and starvation. What is malnutrition? Malnutrition is a condition in which people do not get an proper amount of food. And starvation means shortage of food. So bhook se jo pareshan hai un logo ko problems hona. MCQs. Due to excessive rainfall, crops get destroyed by floods. What causes shortage of food in the market? Hoarding, black marketing or both of these? Answer will be both of these. Next topic is deficiency diseases. So what are deficiency diseases? Deficiency means shortage, kami hona. So diseases that are caused due to lack of nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins and vitamins in our diet are called deficiency diseases. And these diseases caused in those people who do not get enough food to eat suffer from malnutrition. Yes, the people who suffer from malnutrition, they do not get enough food because they don't have money to purchase the food at high prices. These diseases are caused in them. So these are called deficiency diseases. So here are a table of some deficiency diseases and the nutrient due to which they caused and the what are the symptoms and food giving deficient nutrient. First is marasmus. Marasmus is a disease of children and it is caused due to lack of proteins, fats and carbohydrates in the diet. What are its symptoms? Child becomes so thin. You can see in the picture the ribs of the child can be seen easily. So loose folds of skin can be seen. And what type of food we should give them? Rice, wheat, potato, maize, eggs, fish, meat, nuts and honey. That means the foods which are rich in carbohydrates, fats and proteins. Kawashiorkor. Kawashiorkor is a disease which is caused due to deficiency of proteins in which abdomen of the child gets swollen and bulges out. You can see in the picture how its his abdomen is bulges out and the legs become thin. So it is due to deficiency of protein. So people should give them milk, fish, eggs, meat and pulses. These are the protein rich food items. Next is anemia. Anemia is a disease which is caused due to deficiency of mineral iron. So the blood carries less oxygen in the body, which results tiredness, loss of appetite, weight, eggs, pulses, cereals and green vegetables should be given to them. Goiter. Goiter is the disease in which thyroid gland swells up and it is caused due to deficiency of iodine. So you can see the swelling in the neck region and how it can be resolved by giving them fish, seafood and iodized salt. Improper development of bones and teeth. It is due to calcium and phosphorus. As we know, calcium is very important for bones and teeth. So due to deficiency of calcium and phosphorus, bones and teeth are not properly developed and they become weak and brittle. So what should we give them? Milk, green vegetables, meat, fish, pulses and nuts. Rickets. Rickets is a disease which is caused due to deficiency of vitamin D. Yes, there are six types of vitamins, vitamin A, B, C, D, E and K. So due to deficiency of vitamin D, rickets is caused in which legs will be bent, deformed bones, stunted growth. We should give them milk, fish and eggs. Night blindness. It is a disease which is caused due to deficiency of vitamin A in which people cannot see in dim light or at the night time. So protein rich, vitamin A rich diet should be given to those people like carrot, mango, papaya, butter, milk, fish, etc. Beriberi. Beriberi is a disease in which skin becomes dry and weak and the nervous system and the muscle cells are also affected and it is caused due to deficiency of vitamin B. So vitamin B is rich in milk, eggs, meat, green leafy vegetables and whole grains. And the last is scurvy. Scurvy is a disease which is due to the deficiency of vitamin C and its symptoms are swelling and bleeding of gums. Citrus fruits, which are juicy fruits like lemon, orange, amla and tomatoes, we should give them to complete the deficiency of vitamin C. Now it's time for book part. This plays the most important role in crop production. Water, food or shelter? Answer will be water. Malnutrition leads to deficiency diseases. Most of the farmers depend on dash water for their crops. Rain. A person suffering from night blindness cannot see in dim light. Circle the odd one. Flood, earthquake, volcanic eruption and hoarding. So answer will be hoarding because flood, earthquake, volcanic eruptions, these are natural calamities, but hoarding is a human-made reason. Marasmus, Kawashiorkor, malaria, goiter. Answer will be malaria because marasmus, Kawashiorkor and goiter are the diseases विच आर कॉज ड्यू टू डेफिशिएंसी ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट, बट मलेरिया इज कॉज्ड ड्यू टू मॉस्किटोज. बोथ होर्डिंग एंड ब्लैक मार्केटिंग आर डैश इलीगल, लीगल और स्टारवेशन. आंसर विल बी इलीगल. When the abdomen of a child gets swollen and bulges out, he is suffering from dash. Answer will be Kevorkian. So by this, we have revised this chapter. Keep reading. Stay safe at home. Have a nice day.